Reunion at the Mela. Once there occurred a total eclipse of the sun of a great magnitude. It was a rare and sacred occasion for the Hindus. People from all parts of the Bharatakanta thronged at Kurukshetra to take bath in the Samantaka Panchakam, made holy by Parashurama. Sri Krishna, Balarama and all the Yadavas from Dwaraka went there. From Vrindavan, Nanda and Yashoda with all the Gopas and Gopis had come. Many kings had come, including Duryodhana and others from Hastinapura, Yudhishthira and others from Indraprastha. People bathed in the sacred lakes, fasted for a day or two, gave large gifts and feasts to Brahmins, and then they broke their fast. After they had sufficient rest, they began to meet one another in turns and thus met many friends and relatives whom they had not met for a very long time. The Gopas and Gopis met Sri Krishna and Balarama and expressed regret at their long separation. They were pacified and were initiated into self-knowledge by Sri Krishna. They were overjoyed and forgot all their worries. Kunti met Vasudeva and his sons. Many kings paid their respects to Sri Krishna and Balarama, knowing it to be a golden opportunity for them to do so. On the ladies' side, Sri Krishna's wives met Kunti, Draupadi and the other consorts of the Pandavas. And there was a lot of conversation between them. Draupadi humbly requested the consorts of Sri Krishna to narrate the tales of their wedding with Sri Krishna. What adventures he had to meet. It is always so entertaining to hear of the ways in which he acts through his yoga maya. Rukmini, Satyabhama, Jambavati, Kalindi, Mitravinda, Bhadra and Nagnajiti narrated their stories. Then Lakshmana narrated her special story. Brihatsena was her father. He knew the mind of his daughter that she wanted to marry the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna. Lakshmana continued, "So my father contrived a plan for the Swayamvara. He fixed a fish on the top of a pole, but it was not visible to the eye. A plate of water was placed at the bottom. By seeing the image, the fish had to be brought down with an arrow. Many kings tried and failed. Others could not even attempt. Duryodhana, Karna, Bhima, Jarasandha and Shishupala had tried and failed. Arjuna tried and he could touch the fish with an arrow, but the fish did not fall down. Then Sri Krishna shot up one arrow and the fish fell down. I placed my garland over his neck and my father sent me with the Lord along with many presents. On the way, the other wicked kings attacked the Lord, but they were either killed, wounded or vanquished. They ran away. We reached Dwaraka and our wedding was celebrated on a very grand scale. The stories of the 16,000 princesses were briefly narrated by Rohini. Thus, they convey to each other their devotion and self-surrender to the Lord. A large assembly of sages arrived at the place where Sri Krishna was. Among them were Krishna Dvaipayana, Vyasa, Devrishi, Narada, Vasishta, Galava, Brihu, Pulastya, Kashyapa, Atri, Markandeya, Brihaspati, Vishwamitra, Satananda, Bharadvaja, Gautama, Parashurama, Sanaka, Sanandana, Sanatana, Sanatkumara, Angira, Agastya, Yajnavalkya, Vamadeva and many other great rishis. Sri Krishna and others stood up on seeing them, received them with due honor and bowed to them all. When the sages were comfortably seated, Sri Krishna addressed them as follows. Today, our lives are highly blessed by your approach. Sacred waters and idols in famous temples have the capacity to purify man only when he resorts to them and worships them for a long time. But holy men purify man by their mere sight and proximity. The five elements, the sun, moon, etc., cannot completely remove our sins, but they create more diversity and delusions, whereas sages of wisdom wipe off our sins if we serve them even for a few minutes. The sages kept silent over these pregnant words of the Lord because they concluded that the Lord was addressing the laymen of the world and teaching them a lesson. When the Lord had finished, the sages addressed the Lord thus, "O Lord, Brahma and great sages like Narada cannot understand the wondrous ways in which you act. We are but deluded by your Maya. Your actions do not bind you. It is all a sport for you. You act with form and without form. You can be known only through the Vedas. The Vedas are known through Brahmins. So Brahmins are very dear to you. You honor them. The kings and princes assembled here cannot know your real nature because your yoga maya deludes them. Great sages of ripe knowledge realize you. You are the sole refuge of the saints. Please shower your grace on us so that we may not be subject to the influence of your maya. You can be realized only when the ego is completely eliminated." So saying, the sages took leave of the Lord and were about to move away. Vasudeva got up and saluted them and asked them to be seated and inquired of them the way by which one could get rid of every kind of karma and the desire for karma phala. Devarishi Narada replied, "Vasudeva considers Sri Krishna, the Lord Supreme, as his son, and so he has this doubt. Proximity leads to loss of reverence. People living on the bank of the Ganges make pilgrimage to distant sacred waters and exhibit their ignorance. The Lord is wisdom, but on account of the play of the three gunas, he appears as though veiled. O Vasudeva, the best way to neutralize karma and the desire for karma phala is to worship the Supreme Lord Vishnu through sacrifices, spending large amounts earned by fair means. By this, the desire for wealth is got rid of and one can renounce desires. You have really worshipped the Lord very well in your previous births. That is why he is born as a son to you." Hearing this, Vasudeva requested the sages to inaugurate a sacrifice then and there. Many sacrifices were performed by Vasudeva under their kind supervision. Many presents were given to the rishis and supervisors and other dependents. After the Avabrita Snana in the Samantaka Panchakam, the sages took leave of Vasudeva and went their way. Vasudeva gave many presents to the kings and relatives assembled there and parted from them. Nanda stayed on for some more time and Vasudeva expressed to him his gratitude and love for having looked after his children like his own when they were in Vraja. When all the relatives and kings had left, the monsoon appeared to be fast approaching and Vasudeva with Sri Krishna and Balarama moved back to Dwaraka.